do is I do bulletproof coffee where I put butter in your coffee, which is really cool. Yeah, you Google it. It's a real thing. I didn't make it up. It's not just like I like butter, but it's good for like fat burning and cognitive developments and hunger as well. So I do that instead of like breakfast sandwich. Google it. Your face is creeping me out. Not just like in general, but about this general situation, about this conversation. But Google it. It's a real thing. I don't buy the really expensive coffee because I just go like this to get my coffee in the morning. But maybe someday I will. But I do the bulletproof coffee. That's it. Just butter. We can talk later, Janet. You look very confused. Okay, we'll chat later. Not the time. Corporations. We are a nation of corporations, from sea to shining sea. They have defined our legislation, our lifestyle, our landscape, everything. The country's oldest corporation is Caswell Macy. Anyone familiar? They were founded in 1752, and they've never hired a marketing person, apparently, because nobody knows who they are. They are a thriving perfume and soap company, like a $20 million company today. Still around. They're still around. You can go on, probably online, maybe. I don't know if they've heard about the internet since 1752 is when they started in Newport, Rhode Island, by an apothecary. So, 1972. They're still around. So from our humble beginnings, today we have 1.7 million traditional C corporations. There's different categorizations when it comes to tax code, but 1.7 million corporations to this day. Given the large number and their large influence in revenue and number of people that they hire and maintain, they have a ton of influence. And even more so, I would say recently in the political realm. Anybody familiar with Citizens United? For those of you who are not, I'll give a brief synopsis. I won't go too far into it. Again, you can Google that. My entire speech you can Google. You can Google me if you want. In 2009, a case was brought to the Supreme Court about political spending during the political time. In a 5-4 ruling, it was ruled unconstitutional that the government restriction on independent political spending by corporations and unions. So unconstitutional that the government can regulate who spends money on politics. Anybody can. And they defined anybody as corporations. The decision overturned a century-old precedent allowing the government to regulate such spending. And as a result, Citizens United has greatly affected the way corporations and unions can spend. So just so you're aware, we're in the first big election after the Citizens United thing that corporations have affected. So Hannah, you good on this one? Perfect. Awesome. what are your thoughts about Citizens United and political spending? And because of the room and we're at work, just try to keep it to the ruling and not your political party or candidacy, although there's probably another time for that. I can't see the thumbs up. Everybody saw the thumbs up? Everyone saw the thumbs up? Citizens United. Basically, now anybody, including corporations, can give money to political parties and political people. Before they couldn't. Now they can. So U.S. Bank can give millions of dollars to candidate of your choice.
The more parties, the more colors there are in the government, the more people will feel represented. And in a country that is so big and so powerful in the world, it's kind of a mess, I think. And I hope that changes. with that, I feel that the people of the United States don't have as much say as to who goes into the government and becomes president, even though they go to vote, because it's eventually the delegates that get to choose, and then they're not really honoring the people's choice.
It's true.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you. In true political fashion, you shifted and answered it beautifully, and now sound bites on Santa. I like it. U.S. system broken. Hannah, that's what I got from your political things. I love the fact that integrity was shown for corporations. I don't understand the relation and correlation, but I'll talk to you about that later. joke. Another thing that corporations have given us is... What? I'm Ron Hogan? This is not a cattle call. You had your turn. Get her out of here. Sorry, that's my Trump. Another thing that corporations has given us is office betting. Whether it's the NCAA, The Bachelor or Bachelorette, or a death pool, real thing, betting on activities outside of your control has become a corporate staple. Laura, what betting pools, brackets, do you take part in?
Thank you, Jim. Sadly, I do have to admit, I used to be a part of the Bachelor, Bachelorette betting. I did it with a few coworkers. We dropped off the bandwagon last season. I don't know what happened. We just didn't pull it together. But basically, we just put in like $2 and we pick candidates who we think are going to win. It's definitely not a show for everyone, but I mean, we like to do it, and it's fun to do that. So it's a free website that you like go to, and you basically like it sets it up for you, and we just put in like the $2 like on the side. It's not like through the website or anything, so it's not like actually gambling online or anything like that.
Just let the record show. She only wasted company time, not her own money. So
yeah.
It's
like. What is it called? Reality TV? Or... I don't know. Okay, I don't know. It's this website. There's lots of shows. You can set up whatever you want on there. So.
And Joe Marion was a part of it.
Oh! I knew that was going to come out. I knew.
So,
I don't.
Let's see if Joe was part of it. But it's a lot of fun.
That's true.
It's
not true.
Thank you.
Woo! That is absolutely true. My wife forced me to watch it. So it was fun because like some of the things that they got points for were like crying and when they would fight and stuff. So I didn't do that well. I don't know. Let's talk about The Bachelor at a different time, at a different setting. One of my coworkers is actually in a death pool. So with a couple of people, they pick people who are going to pass away in a calendar year. And then when they, Chad's yep. Nodding his head like he doesn't, when they're nodding away, when they pass away, you get like points. And they put significant money into this pool. Several hundred dollars. I think the grand prize in there is like $1,000. It's like the weirdest thing. So every time I see somebody die, I'm like, who just made money? So. I don't think so, unless you like kill them, I think. And for the $1,000, I don't think it's worth it. I'd rather like take an insurance policy out on them and then kill them, but that's again, not the time to plot people's murder, Anna. Let's go, okay. I don't have any facts to support this next claim. But.
I think the president said that.
I think so, yeah. Very political. So, no facts, but corporations invented meetings. 100%. From annual reviews to weekly discussions to biannual budget reviews to discuss Q4 marketing results, and so on and so forth and so on. The list is endless, and so are the meetings. Janet, what meeting do you love the most, and what meeting do you loathe?
In grad school, his work was the thing that you got done in between coffee. So, meetings. Anything that I don't have to stand up and present is a great meeting. I am not want to go in front of the technology console and go, hey, look at this really cool. Oh, let's run away. Meetings that I find entertaining are meetings at the dog park. When you get to meet your girlfriend with coffee and you let the dogs run around and kill each other. Sort of. In which case, then when you bring the dog home, the dog doesn't hurt cats around the house, which is really convenient. So, different meetings, different times. The other good meeting that I enjoy is Chinese food and chick flicks. Occasionally, I do need my estrogen, being in a male-dominated world. Bunch of girls come over. We all make Chinese food. We actually make our own Chinese food. We don't order it. And we watch chick flicks. Usually, we end up throwing things at the TV or yelling obscenely. The Notebook is one of my favorites to throw things at. Stupid, stupid, stupid.
I know, right? I lost my man card at this meeting.
Good. Meetings are, and I are a very love-hate relationship.
I like it. Thank you, Janet. So would you consider that like a Netflix and MSG? A little bit?
No. It's Netflix, not quite Netflix and chill.
Okay. I assume, yeah, the Netflix and MSG I thought was...
I don't know.
It wasn't a real question.
Chocolate.
Yeah, I like it. Chinese food and chocolate. It sounds like
doesn't
a good.
Go very
well. It sounds like a good. Sounds like a good time. I like making my own Chinese food as well. Off topic completely. Online, there is a map of different corporations. I'm intentionally not showing you because this is part of the question. So some examples are. Starbucks in Washington State, of course, birthplace of coffee. Coca-Cola in Georgia, birthplace of soda. And then Hooters in Florida, birthplace of, well, moving on. Brittany convinces that a state of your choosing should be represented by a corporation of your choosing. For extra points, don't do Minnesota. Don't cheat. There's a lot of them. There's at least 52.
Thank you, Tabletop Exchange. Well, I think that Chicago should be...
Illinois.
Well, yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
I don't even know.
There's
so many that it's hard not to think outside of the box.
I don't know.
Maybe the coffee tastes different. I guess we didn't get any there. So that was fun. I know I'm kind of redirecting this question for you, but I think that you should start your own little coffee shop, Chad, because it sounds very interesting. I, myself, my old college roommate was a barista. So every time I'd go in there, she'd make me something different. And she actually convinced me to buy myself an espresso machine. So I have one, and I used it in college quite a bit. Kind of gotten away from it because I'd take the convenient Keurig route. But it is fun to actually do that and have the process. Not as intense as yours, but I do like making my own espresso as well. So I definitely think it'd be fun to try out your espresso. Maybe you should have that speech and give samples, because that would be great.
Take a significant... Woo. I would take a significant amount of time. I don't have a schedule in front of me, so am I good? One more? We're wrapping it up. Wrap it up, Joe. Wrap it up. He's going to tuck me off stage. We are a nation of corporations. They will continue to define our legislation, lifestyle, and landscape. It's Trailsmaster.